genres. Perhaps more than the business skills of the moguls or the technical resources of the big studios, more than the attractiveness of the stars and the skills of the directors, it is the popular genres that have most typified American film and given it its greatest strength and vitality. The conventions of genre, fixed yet capable of infinite variation, have supported the given strength to the work of many of the finest American screenwriters and directors. Genres bear a complex relation to the society that produced them, expressing the dreams, the anxieties, and the ambivalences of that era. During the 1920s, all of the major type of American films were present, except, of course, the musical, which required sound. The Western embodied some of the United States' most resonant national myths, the concept of land as private property, and the rationalization of the conquest of indigenous people by the European settlers. The genre started with The Great Train Robbery, 1903, and matured most notably in the films produced by Thomas Ince, starring William S. Hart, such as The Gunfighter, 1916. In the 1920s, the epic Western was added to the line: The Last of the Mohicans, 1921, The Covered Wagon, 1923, The Iron Horse, 1924, directed by John Ford. Hart continued to work until 1925, and Tumbleweeds was his last and probably finest film. He was succeeded in popularity by Tom Mix, Buck Jones, Tim McCoy, Hoot Gibson, Ken Maynard, and some lesser stars. When the comedy genre moved from the one and two reelers into features in the 1920s, that time became known as comedy's greatest era. The wonderful clowns, Charlie Chaplin, Buster Keaton, Harold Lloyd, Harry Langdon, created their masterworks during this time. They confirmed and advanced the early discoveries and pioneering insights of Mack Sennett, making silent film comedy an art form, giving it timeless and universal pleasure. The features include Chaplin's The Kid, 1921, The Gold Rush, 1925, Keaton's The Navigator, 1924, and The General, 1927, Harold Lloyd's Safety Last, 1923, and The Freshman, 1925, and Harry Langdon's The Strong Man and Tramp, 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 both from 1926, along with continuing shorts of Stan Laurel and Oliver Hardy and others. These films gave American screen comedy an impetus that carries it through the 1940s and beyond. If we include the work of Danny Kaye, Red Skelton, Jerry Lewis, Woody Allen, and Mel Brooks within the tradition, and maybe Dan Aykroyd and Bill Murray as well, the influence of the comedies of the 1920s has extended to the present. Although the introduction of sound required extreme modifications of style and introduced a new group of comics, the comedy, along with the Western, gangster film, and the musical, remains among the most distinctive, indigenous, and important American contribution to film forms.